Hi, welcome back to another vlog. Say hello. It's Friday, the 19th of March. It's like, you know, Friday catch-up day. Catch up on laundry, water the plants. We have a coffee date with a friend soon. Wow, do I look crazy? What else do I want to say? Other than I'm just gonna start filming a new vlog. Do you want to say something? Thank you for all the sweet, sweet, sweet comments on the last one, because I was so afraid that it was a jumbled mess of a disaster tornado vlog, and everyone said really nice things, so thank you for that.
And I will go shave now.
Okay. I also started reading a new book per recommendation of Rebecca from Rebecca Eats Books. We've decided together, it's been decided that we are reading Soulmates. So for sure, like anything she reads for the rest of time, I will also read probably. So she was talking about Swimming Home by Deborah Levy. And also CJ wrote me when I posted on Instagram that she loved this book also. So win, win, win in all directions for me. And I'm in the middle of it. It's amazing. I love it so far. It's my first Levy book, so I'll sit down a little bit later probably, and talk to you more about it and catch you up on my reading. But that is what I'm reading, if you're wondering. I have been tagged officially also by Rebecca to do the could do better tag that CJ made about like really bad book covers. So I'm gonna maybe try to film that today also. So I swear the hair just gets bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. Okay, gonna go on with our afternoon and meet a friend, and then I'll catch up with you later.
Sunglasses.
Like outbound. Outbound.
Snea.
Ben wanted to say something. And
what did we do today?
We had a coffee.
We went shopping for a second. I bought those pants.
Really expensive pants.
But it's my birthday on Tuesday, and they were just the perfect navy trousers that I've been looking for, and there they were, and so it was just meant to be. I started filming earlier an update on Swimming Home by Deborah Levy, and I just felt like I need to keep reading before I say things, because I was just trying to get my thoughts out, and then I just couldn't find what I wanted to say, so I'm gonna hold off and probably read further or finish it and then talk to you about it. But I'm gonna link below Rebecca's review of this book, because it's flawless, and I just felt like I would just repeat like so many things of what she said, and it's just so not, I would rather you hear it in her beautiful words. So I'm gonna leave her video down there, and you can click on it, and you must watch it for sure if you either read this book or want to read this book, or just interested. I think she can articulate, she articulated it so well. And I'm sure I will have my own distinct thoughts about it when I finish, so I'll update you when that happens. But overall, the thing I can say that I'm really enjoying is the fact that this book is taking place in one location with a set kind of cast of characters. I love that kind of, I mean, I can also enjoy if
a story is like moving through generations, or if it's moving through, or I don't know, if it's fucking time traveling or something, it's also fine. I really, really like this kind of like immersive experience inside, like 1 week in one place with these characters that you can really just get to know in different ways. And I really like a character piece, or like a piece that's, yeah, that exists in like its own little world. Also, I feel like who has the film rights? Someone needs to have the film rights for this, because it would be a really, really interesting film, I think, like in my opinion. If I was a filmmaker, I would make it. But I really like Deborah Levy's writing so far, and she's such a smart lady. She's so smart, and I really enjoy that she's really, really, really intelligent, but it's like very accessible. So it's, yeah, like you can enjoy to read it, but while you're reading it, you're like, whoa, she is one of a kind. So I was just watching the new reading vlog, or like life of a bookseller, by Ignacia, or Iggy, from Literary Iggy. And she said there in the video that we're like BookTube besties, and I really smiled like to my ears. I love her. You have to go watch her channel. I'll leave it in the down bar, in the description. But she's just amazing. So I was just watching that, and I really enjoyed. And Ohad made banana bread. It's really tasty. What else can I say? We're gonna probably order sushi. And maybe I'll read. I also think it's becoming a tradition to talk about wine also. So I'll share with you what we're drinking tonight. It's rosé today. This is an Italian rosé. Very light and kind of fruity, but still dry. It's very, very, very good. Good morning, it's Saturday. It's earlier than I usually am awake, but Ohad is on a video shoot today for kind of like a video to raise awareness for voting, which is really good. So, what was that hand gesture? Anyway, so I'm up, and I think I can't go back to sleep, so. But it's very sunny and quiet outside. It's so beautiful. So there's one coffee shop that's open on Saturdays. Two, actually. So I might walk and get something and read a little bit this morning. I don't know if you can really see, but these are the pants that I bought yesterday that I was speaking about. There's no real good place to, I don't know, try to show you clothes. Yeah, I guess this is working. Anyway, I really love them. You know, just sometimes you gotta buy yourself something nice. So it turns out that the coffee shop I went to doesn't open for another 30 minutes, but it's okay. It's so quiet, like I said. Like, the city is never really quiet. And I maybe passed 3 people in total on the street, and it was so nice to take a little walk. There's no one around me, so I guess I can take this off for a second. So I'm just gonna sit here with my Kindle and read a little bit, and then
when they open. I'm gonna get a coffee. No one cares about any of this, but I'm just telling you. Bringing you along for my day. Hi, good morning. It's Monday. We're before work, so I thought I would just come in and update you before. Last night I finished Swimming Home by Deborah Levy. Wow. So like I said, I really recommend, I'm gonna link the review from Rebecca about this book because I find a lot of parallels with what she said in her video about this book, the importance of language and, or just the difference in language between an artist and a reporter or a war correspondent, so the husband and wife, and how they really have a different just relationship with words and how words affect them and how words infect them. So what I really enjoyed about this was, well, on one level, on like maybe the top level, I really enjoyed just the kind of, you know, infiltration of this stranger into a family vacation, into a family dynamic. I really love stories that we sort of meet the characters, especially somewhere that's kind of like looks very nice from the outside, like a villa vacation in, you know, the French Riviera. It sounds beautiful. And I love to like kind of see the breaking apart of the situation or the characters. Although it can also be hard to read that and can be devastating sometimes, but it's interesting to watch this kind of crumbling, I think. On one level, I really liked the kind of uncanny, mysterious elements of this book. And then on the other side, I just really loved the style. I loved the repetition. Levy's repeating a lot of like scenes. She's revisiting them. Like we read the same passages a few times, a little bit differently each time, which I thought was really smart and really beautiful. I also wrote like something about this book is very immersive in the sense that like I feel like the book is almost engulfing you or like surrounding your, like I felt it was surrounding me when I was reading it, especially towards the latter half of the book. And I felt like sounds were a prevalent thing that I got from this. Like, I mean, she describes every detail of everything, but like there was a feeling like, almost like as I was reading it, like my ears were ringing, like in a very visceral way. Yeah, I thought there was like a tension in certain moments to like the sounds that she would describe that were very, very affecting, I think. I also feel like there's so much imagery that she adds in that like all I feel like is connected to or symbolizes like bigger themes. Like I know CJ was talking about how for her this book was really about depression, and I can totally see that. Definitely, yeah, about family, about partnership, about depression. definitely, especially in two specific characters, the husband and Kitty Finch. But all of the characters kind of are, like, have seeds of deep sadness or depression. And I just thought, like, simple imagery, like this beautiful villa that has cockroaches inside it. She, like, describes the cockroaches. It's kind of like something thing is crawling underneath, or the house could be a body. I just thought it could symbolize, like, this idea of how depression crawls through the body. So there were some also, like, very poetic passages that I thought tied together with, like, bigger themes. Although I do have to be honest that at some points I wondered if I was missing a bigger theme. Like, I read other reviews, I watched other videos that, like, definitely influenced me and that I can agree with, but I did wonder if maybe under the surface she was commenting on certain things that maybe I wasn't getting sometimes. I don't know. But we're definitely, you know, looking at language and what it means to make art and how that, how words can reflect the inside of the mind and the inside of the soul, kind of. And parenthood and how children are affected by the absence of parents in life. I'm gonna link other reviews, I think, that might describe this better than me. But I did really, really enjoy, and I definitely think I would recommend it, for sure. Beautiful. Levy's writing is really, really beautiful. So I'm thinking next I'm gonna read either one of, like, the first memoir, like, I think she called it Living Autobiography by Levy. So I might move on to that and just make it, like, a Levy kind of period. I read more of her stuff. Or I'm gonna read Elena Savage's Blueberries. I'm home from work. I'm just reflecting on my thoughts on Swimming Home. I'm still processing things about it because I feel like this book exists in many layers, and I feel like there is no sentence in this book that isn't there for a purpose. So I also feel like I could benefit from a reread at some point of this book. I feel like that book and also, like, Outline that I just read by Rachel Cusk, like, different, very different, but I feel like it's a good, I'm on, like, a roll of books that really make me ask questions to myself about them, that pique, like, questions about communication, words, the inner world of a person, and darkness, and all these things, like reflection, observation. These are, like, themes I find myself inside right now, and so I really enjoyed Swimming Home very, very much. I'm in between Things I Don't Want to Know, also by Deborah Levy. It's her first living autobiography in her, like, series of three, I think. I'm in between that and Blueberries by Elena Savage, which also came very highly recommended from Rebecca. She said, like, that her channel has officially become a Elena Savage, like, fan account. Yeah, so far I've really, really vibed with everything that she has mentioned. So I feel like Blueberries is probably the next one I'm gonna read. And I already started reading the sample, and wow, it's strong. So yes, I think that's where I'm headed. Tomorrow is my birthday. So we're actually throwing, like, a little party at the apartment. Tonight. Tomorrow is the day that everyone in the country goes to vote. Well, hopefully, like, people are voting. So most of the country, like, has the day off, actually. So tomorrow, on my actual birthday, I think
of like renting a car and driving somewhere a little bit outside of the city for like a picnic. Also, we want margaritas tonight, so I'm gonna go hunt down margarita ingredients. Guys, I'm officially 25. It's my day of birth today. Margaritas I was speaking of, yeah, they really worked. So we had a bit of a hangover this morning, but that's okay. It was a successful little party. And also, do you love my glasses? Ohad, my boyfriend, got me these, blue light glasses, because now that I'm doing BookTube, I'm like editing videos a lot on my computer and just like in general, like in front of the computer screen more. And like I read on my Kindle and I look at my phone a lot in the evening, and I just like, I know that it's, some people say it's like just a placebo, like it's not real. I don't care. Even if it's just for the feeling of it. And I actually really like, love glasses, but I don't need them. Whoa! So I'm very excited and I feel like super scholarly with them. So you can let me know what you think. I'm sorry about the glare. But anyways, I had a very nice, birthday party, and today we're just taking it slow and gonna maybe rent a car and drive somewhere. I'm not sure. I'm feeling not attached to any specific plan. I feel like I just wanna go by the hour and see how I feel. And the weather is so weird. I think I mentioned it before. It's like muggy, gray, almost foggy, but then really hot. Just terrible. So I don't know if that's like the best picnic weather. But anyway, that's, we'll see how the day goes and what I end up doing. Also, I just want to say on here many days after, because I don't know when this video is going to go up, but I got such sweet like birthday wishes from my new BookTube friends. They actually sent me messages before my real life friends. Some of them. So that was really sweet, and it just confirmed to me more and more how lovely this little BookTube community is. And my new bookish internet friends, I really like, I really love it, and it makes my heart so warm. Wish I could give you some like things I've learned in my 24 years so far. I don't know, guys. Live your life, enjoy, believe in yourself. What can you do? Yeah, so what else do I want to say? Like, happy to be on the earth, as crazy as it is a place to live. Okay, I think that's all for now. Yeah, I don't know. Also, Han just came home and gave me these beautiful flowers.
What a feast.
The birthday boy.
Hi.
Cheers.
Hi friends, so I'm coming to you. I don't remember what the last clip that I shot is, but I'm just coming to conclude this vlog and wrap it up and say that, yeah, I just thought that I would maybe keep going with it, but then I started editing it and it got to about like 25 minutes or something, and not that I don't enjoy long videos, I just think that the main focus of this vlog was Rachel Cusk and reading outline and reading my first book by her. So I feel like we concluded that part, and that was kind of the focus of this. So I did want to update you and say that I'm about like 15% through blueberries, and it's really, it's incredible. I'm so, it's a wow. I'm having to like take pause after few paragraphs. Really, every few paragraphs I'm like, whoa, wow, she is amazing. It's really blowing my mind, and it's just incredible. I won't finish it in the next few days just because of like things that I have going on. And I didn't want to extend this vlog to be like 3 weeks of footage. So I'm gonna end it here. Of course, I will keep you updated on blueberries. I'll either start a new vlog or just update you in a later video. I just feel like it's a good time to end the vlog. So thank you so much for watching and all your support and all your love. And I will keep doing it, I think. It was really fun for me so far, this whole experience. So yeah, thanks. And I hope you stay happy and healthy. And I'm gonna make dinner now, some pasta and butternut squash in the oven. So, bye. See you later. Thanks for watching.